Zara. And that's horrible. At the PA Q&A, we learned about this terrible danger coming for you. If anybody wants that script and Leisha Day, just run.
Yes.
Hey, Ryan Steven, I was just curious if you consider what you do now to be kind of the end product of the foreshadowing that your character in Stand By Me, you know, how he was a storyteller or something.
You know, it's really weird to me that, look, I think one of the reasons Stand By Me is the movie that it is, and one of the reasons that it's endured for 30-something, 25, 25 years? Long enough that I don't know if it's 25 or 30 years. This has nothing to do with me being 39, so shut up. Oh, I guess 25 years goes to 9 when I made it. Look at that, I used math! I just like to apologize to my ninth grade algebra teacher, Mr. Cummings. It turns out that I did actually use this someday. I think that one of the reasons the movie endures the way it does is because Rob Reiner had the presence of mind to cast four boys who were essentially those characters. And then we did our very best, well, I mean, I did my very best to just not screw it up and just, you know, just do what the material demanded of me. And it doesn't surprise me that I grew up to do what I do. I wrote about this in just a key, like I kind of felt like, well, maybe I'm supposed to be a writer because when I was, you know, 14, look at those guys. Remember when people wore their sunglasses on strings like that? It was, I remember doing these interviews and sort of feeling like people were like, so are you going to be a writer? And I was like, yeah, I guess. And I think I'm supposed to say yes to everything you ask me. When do I get the candy? I'm confused. This is an interview. Why are we doing it in a van and there's no camera? That's where the camera is. Okay. An adult. The answer is I don't know. But I think that there's probably a correlation, if not a causation. Yes?
Can I have a hug?
No. Sorry. I know, now I'm the asshole now. Here's the thing. I got the swine flu at PAX in 09, and as a result of that, I am scared to death of getting it again. I leave here Sunday, and I go straight back to Vancouver to work on Eureka to finish the season. And then I go straight to DragonCon for 4 days. And I understand that DragonCon is just, it's just full of like furry spores in the air. And so I'm going to be cosplaying as a guy in a Tyvek suit. It's absolutely nothing personal, but I actually kind of like avoid human contact. And I'm super sorry.
Aww.
I know, I'm awful.
Okay.
No, listen, I miss out on touching a lot of pretty girls.
First quick thing, will you be wearing the Cape of Dix to tomorrow's evening session?
Statistically possible. What I have to actually do is I have to check the stats and see what bonuses Cape of Dix gives.
And this is why you're a good gamer.
Thanks.
So, real question, and I almost feel like a heel asking this after your Callum Nee story, but every time I read about you playing role-playing games, you're playing Dungeons & Dragons, you're playing Dragon Age, Gamma World, but you always talk about the importance of creating these stories
right.
And acting out these characters, and sometimes just totally ignoring the rules in favor of that. Have you ever tried the really rules-like games? I think you might enjoy quite a lot.
I don't know. Do you consider Fiasco rules light?
Fiasco is like the rules lightest of rules light games, yeah.
That's my favorite RPG of all time.
Amazing. That's
it's my favorite thing ever. We're actually my friends and I are getting together to play it tonight. I love it. And it's been sort of described as a GM-less game, but my friend behind Mark said, actually, I think it's sort of a GM-full game, because everyone's GM in that game. I ultimately think that the rules are there to give you a structure to work within, and to sort of let people who are starting to play a game I just realized I'm wearing a Cape of Dix. The rules are there to give you some place to start, and the longer you play, the more you can kind of figure out what you like and what you don't like. And I don't think there's a single experienced RPGer in the world who hasn't just thrown out rules they don't like.
Sure.
And when I talk about guys that just sort of want to argue about the rules, like I think they're really missing the point. So, I mean, even when we have played the most rules-heavy games ever, one of the reasons that I love character creation so much is that I spent high school playing GURPS.
Oh, and
it was, no, I love it. It's great. Steve Jackson's sitting right there, so... So yeah, rules like I love Inspectors, Primetime Adventures. I have Dresden Files, but I haven't played it yet because it weighs too much for me to carry it anywhere. Awesome. Now I've really managed to use up all of my time answering your question. See what happens.